G'day guys, I've been sent this situation here to review. Some of you may have seen it before. It's not a very pleasant one. Unfortunately, this guy's come and harassed a man and his family at their house. I don't have any other further information, and it's a little bit hard to judge and evaluate, you know, or assess the situation, but let's have a crack at it.
We're going out.
Stop.
Don't do that, mate. I'm on you.
Don't do it.
Move away from my house.
So he's warning the guy. Now he's starting to take his shirt off. Okay, kids are screaming, not having a good time. Obviously, that's not cool. He looks like he used to work out. I don't know. I've seen guys like this. I don't know what the deal with the gloves is. He looks a little bit drunk or possibly even high.
No one's trying to piss you off. You're coming to my house in front of my kids. Behaving like you're not being fucking nice. You're
Okay.
Shut off.
Go away from
it's
my house now.
The owner of the house is getting heated.
You're in front of my children. Just move away from my property. For fuck's sake.
Oi, there you go. Alright, so he's asked him to move away. He hasn't. He's been aggressive. He's been intimidating. He could deem that as being threatening. But once you hit him and the guy goes down, and then you then proceed to kick the guy while he's down, in most cases I would say that it's no longer deemed necessary or reasonable use of force. I did used to work with a guy that laid in the boot. It's a guy that used to work doors in a similar vicinity to me here in Australia. I think kicked the guy once after he'd knocked him down, and he did 5 years time in prison. In that point in time, when all you're seeing is red, it's very hard to be, you know, logical and have rational thought processes and all those sort of things. So the thing that I'm trying to say here that's very important to try and remain aware of is not going overboard, not stepping further than, you know, that line of reasonable and necessary use of force. Be it whether he's drunk or high or whatever, he seemed a little bit slurry, a little bit dazed, a little bit, you know, yeah, he could be out of it. You don't know. He might not remember where you knocked him the fuck out. You might put a protection order in place, or because you've got that on camera and it showed you knock the guy out and then kick him, you could actually get yourself in trouble. So, you know, filming things like this can be a great thing to identify the guy after. You can tell your neighbors, look, this is the guy. If you see him in our area, call the police. We've alerted police that he's been hanging around. You know, there could be more to the story, who knows, but that's one thing. But that can work against you as well. So I've had significant others and other people film things when it's kicked off. Jeremy actually has filmed quite a few things for me, my training partner that you've seen in other videos, with previous neighbors that I had kicking off, just meth heads. And there's kids that were 16, 17, who I could now probably legally, you know, deal with in a different way. But yeah, he's filmed things, and it's a good idea most of the time, but if you can't act reasonably and necessary with clarity of mind and be a little bit long-sighted, it can work against you. And in this case, I would say, oh mate, yes, he's standing his ground. I understand his feeling. I probably would have done something very similar, to be honest with you. If the guy's taken his shirt off, maybe, you know, shoved him or said, look, let's walk over here and talk about it, get away from the kids, because you can hear the kids screaming, that sort of thing. But if you knock him down and you hurt him, let's say you cause grievous bodily harm, you'll be charged for that, most likely. On top of that, the guy could come back for round two. Now, he could be part of some sort of biker gang or any sort of gang, any sort of organized crime affiliation he may have. And then really you've got more than you bargained for there, haven't you? So, you know, what you're always trying to do is avoid and prevent situations from becoming worse. This was what I would see as threat management, because the guy showed clear indicators that he did want to fight. He was being assertive, aggressive and intimidating. So yeah, one punch possibly. I don't know how anyone judging that as in law enforcement would have seen it, but you know, the guy's trying to protect his house and his kids, and who knows what, you know, if that guy might have had a knife. That guy to me seemed like he was on something. So, you know, I think he's taken somewhat appropriate steps except for that last kick there. But again, what I'm trying to say is it's a good idea to be long-sighted and aware of the potential for round two. So if you've got any other ideas of how you'd respond or how you act, coulda, shoulda, woulda, hadda, people love to talk about that, don't they? Let us know in the comment section below. If you want to learn more about personal security, self-protection, close quarter combatives and all those other good things we do, check out the link below. We have an offer right now for a week-long trial at our online learning center. We'll see you there.